momentum, four losses, are number one, Serenity Aragon, number 13, Kayla Smith, and number 30, Desiree McGill. Introducing the starters for the Lady Hornets at guard, 5'7" junior number one, Lionel Mosqueda. For the Lady Patriots, starting at guard, 5'10" senior number 00, one of the captains, Ta'Niya Latson.
Good afternoon and welcome inside the RP Funding Center for this afternoon's girls 5A state championship game between the Bishop Moore Hornets and the American Heritage Patriots here on Spectrum Sports. Mike Cairns and Andrick Frazier on the call for you this afternoon, getting ready to crown a 5A state champ here inside the RP Funding Center in Lakeland. Let's take a look. Need to get here as you look at the brackets, and American Heritage just cruised into the championship game, winning by 36 in the finals, 28 in the semifinals, and the defending champs are back once again. Bishop Moore got through Charlotte in a tough semifinal season and almost two steals a game. She has six double doubles on the season.
These two young ladies lead a complete basketball team. They're well rounded and want to get things done offensively and defensively for their club. 42 rebounds and 5 blocks in the semifinals for this club, led by Alyssa Brasco's 10 points and 13 rebounds. They're going to have to play large if they're going to want to step up and contend one of the best players in the country.
Absolutely, and speaking of that player, the senior, there she is, Ta'Niya Latson. She is just absolutely rebounds and 7 assists a game. She's a McDonald's All-American. And she's on her way to Florida State. Take a look at the starting lineup for Bishop Moore. Tiffany Lee and Ella Mosqueda to go along with Merceron Brasco and Brooke Allen to round out the five for Ricky Clay Jr. in his first season as the head coach. And what a first season it has been, 23-6. And the Edgewater grad has taken his Hornets to a state championship game. As for American Heritage, this is how they'll roll out the top five. Gabby Dumas, Imani Theodule, Sydney Studsville, go along with Latson and Joey Delancey for head coach Greg Farias in his 7th season at American Heritage. And it is nothing but rings for that guy right there. The 5th title game appearance, and they have won 4 straight. Pretty impressive for the Patriots.
At the rate he's been going, I'm not sure if FHSAA makes toe rings, but they may want to start doing so.
Well, they're going to go for the thumb today, brother. And we are underway here at the RP Funding Center. 3 ball on the way to get it started. And just like that, a splash is how things roll out.
Theodule letting you show she's ready to get it done. And how about this, American Heritage, early timeout, 18 seconds into the contest. 5-0 lead.
Yeah, Imani Theodule getting it going and followed up with a steal and another bucket. And just like that, it's 5-0. Take a look at the playoff history of this one that we have the time. Bishop Moore Hornets, 19 playoff appearances, 47 postseason wins. Their best finish, they won the state championship back in 08. As for the Patriots of American Heritage, 16 playoff appearances, 40 postseason wins, and 4 consecutive state championships, and they've done it in 2 different divisions.
Only thing I can hear is DJ Khalid in my ears. All we do is win, win, win.
You can sing that anytime you want. You can do that anytime.
Let me warm my voice up first, partner.
All right, okay. 5-0 the lead, and they're looking to add to it. Big rebound there from Alyssa Brasco. One of many, I'm sure, that will be calling her name on the boards tonight, and that one is tied up. So Bishop Moore getting tied up, and they'll have to try and get through this press of American Heritage.
One of the things that makes American Heritage so dangerous is the ability to be able to press off of misses and makes, which, you know, lets you understand your players have awareness on where they need to be on the floor and are almost positionless on this club.
There is Ta'Niya Latson with a pass ahead. to Sydney Studsville. Agent Zero on the run. Goes up and just comes up short. Picks up her own rebound. Sticks it back up and in. Expect that name to be called early and often here in the state title game. Alyssa Brasco to Brooke Allen. Allen can't connect. Brasco fighting for the rebound. American Heritage comes down with it. Nani Fiedel came down with a rebound. Pull-up jumper in and out by Gabrielle Dumas. Tiffany Lee and company back the other way. Linnell Mosquita going to run the show offensively.
Bishop Moore is going to have to make sure not only they take care of the basketball, but look to advance the ball up the floor against this pressure and attack the rim. Not necessarily with speed, but going over the top. This is a Patriots ball club that does not mind gambling. When going for steals, you have to make them pay when they miss.
There's one of our key players with the ball, Alexandra Merceron, the 5'10 sophomore. Handing it off to Alyssa Brasco. Mosquita bothered there. She had to drop it back off to Merceron. Joey DeLancey all over Merceron. You see the way.
Nice cut.
Beautiful cut for Tiffany Lee, but they couldn't connect. They've missed a couple of bunnies here early.
One sure far away to alleviate pressures to make sure you're able to back cut.
Latson is fouled. She'll go to the line. She is so much fun to watch. She can do so many things out on the floor.
It's another one of the ball handlers we've seen so far this afternoon. Just comfortable attacking the rim. 5'10", has the size to finish over taller defenders.
Averaged almost 27 points a game. She's an 81% free throw shooter, a 47% three-point shooter. There's not much that she cannot do.
Great job on the commentator jinx there, partner. Just missed a free throw.
Well, I had to get one. It didn't work last game. Tiffany Lee pulls up. Short. Still looking for their first points. It's an 8-0 start. As Joey DeLancey comes down with a rebound and going the other way. DeLancey flips it up and she's fouled.
I mentioned earlier about this ball club being positionless. Like anyone who gets the basketball has the ability to go coast to coast with this American Heritage ball club. Just see right here DeLancey, inside out move, putting those shoulders down, drawing contact and ability to get two from the charity stripe.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that Coach Freya said. That's a big reason why Ta'Niya Latson had such a great season, because so many people would focus on her. Just what you said, there are so many other girls on the team that can play any position on the floor and are more than comfortable about taking the ball up court. That allows Ta'Niya to get open and play her game and do her thing.
It's part of the evolution of the game that we've seen over the course of the last 20 years where everyone's taught, like, all the skills. So, yeah, 4 and 5s that can step out and shoot the 3, they can handle the basketball. But when you have players that can not only do that, but they understand the game from a guard's position and have high basketball IQ, that makes you dangerous on the offensive end of the floor.
And, partner, if you want to go play at the next level, you better be more than one-dimensional if you want to go play Division I college basketball, right?
Hey, listen, you want to be able to sub in for anyone who has problems. You need to know everybody's position on the floor and have the skill sets to be able to play all five.
Well, Alexander Merceron finally got Bishop Moore on the board. And American Heritage will have the ball as the sub comes in for Bishop Moore. Marceline Claremont is checking in.
Just to give people kind of an idea, like on the way that DeLancey is actually categorized on her sheet is a point guard and power forward. She skipped over two positions. It shows you her versatility on how her coach chooses to play her.
Great pass to Latson, but good defense by Merceron. Latson wants a call for a foul. As she tried to go up over the top at 24, and 24 said, not happening. Gabriella Dumas on the inbound here. There's Latson again, and there's Merceron on her again. I think we'll see that combo a lot today. Flipped up, no good. Dumas comes down with a rebound to Latson. Good ball movement and the foul. DeLancey fed her. That was just a nice little piece of offense right there.
I mean, these young ladies move the basketball so well. See right here, just a one-handed pass, shovel pass over to DeLancey, and then right over into Lassen's hands.
See, you talk about basketball IQ. How about the IQ DeLancey had as soon as she got the ball? She's not going to shoot it down there. She's down there She's behind the basket. What does she do? She feeds the best player on the team.
Well, that's understanding where you are on the court, because honestly, you always want to have a post-up position or a position to score above the block. If you're beneath the block, you have to be able to pass the basketball.
Gabriella Dumas comes up with another steal. And she'll go to the line. Four team fouls already on Bishop Moore. Alexander Merceron already has two of those four. So we'll keep an eye on that. And she is staying in the game. And they need her offensively. There's no doubt about that. Mosqueda comes down with it. Linnell Mosqueda on the move. Flips it up. Short. Monty Theodore with the rebound. Quickly. Latson on the run. Step around. Can't go. And Merceron comes down with a rebound. She has one on three and pulls up. Knocked out of bounds.
Surely a fast-paced game, partner. Both teams not shy to advance the basketball and get a shot off.
And that's the thing about, especially Bishop Moore, they gave him play different styles in the game against Charlotte in the semifinals. It was not this. They did not run up and down the floor. It was a defensive war. Mosqueda gets fouled. And the 5'7 junior will go to the line for the first time this afternoon.
Mosqueda here with the shot fake and dribble penetration and getting Delancey to leave her feet.
First team foul for American. Mosqueda, 60% free throw shooter on the year. 9 points and four rebounds in the semifinal. And handles the point guard duties and runs the offense for Ricky Clay Jr. 12-4 here in the early minutes of the first quarter of the girls 5A state championship game. Mike Cairns and Andrick Frazier on the call for you this afternoon. Hope you're enjoying this one from wherever you are. Living room, on the TV, screaming it, whatever you're doing.
Nice cut. Just basketball awareness right here with the floor being spaced. As a defender, you have to make sure you jump towards the basketball on every pass. You can't allow yourself to be face cut. Latson, just a great nose, knack for scoring. Ball side cut, opportunity to get two from the charity stripe.
Brooke Allen picks up her second foul, so both Allen and Merceron, and there goes Brooke Allen. She's checking out of the game. Simran Singh is going to check in for her. Both Merceron and Allen have quickly collected two fouls here. And Ta'Niya Latson knocks down both. The press, they kind of made it a little bit easier on him, but not for long. Zamani Theodore comes and picks off another one. Gabriella Dumas, Delancey gets double teamed. Right back to Theodore. Theodore, a bunch of black jerseys around her. Wide open underneath. It's Theodore when she can't put it down. Simran Singh just checked in the game. Comes down with a rebound, the 5'11 junior.
Bishop Morris needs to settle down and get a good offensive possession.
Brasco missed on the three. There's Theodore trying to answer with a three. Comes up short to Lancey. Comes down with a rebound looking for some help and then pulls it out.
Nice shot fake.
Theodore rolls it up and in. Brasco comes down with a tip off of Latson. Alexandra Merceron running the show up top now. 16-4 start for American in this one. Mosqueda. Brasco looking around through that American defense. Singh on the handoff. Singh comes down with a loose ball. Latson says, get out of my way.
I guess Latson didn't want to listen to that music at all.
The Tiffany Lee checks in the game. That's Lee with the basketball to Brasco. Brasco trying to get inside around Latson. Latson comes down with a rebound, feeds it up ahead to Theodore. Theodore, left hand is good.
Latson so quick off her feet, able to come up with the deflection, grab the steal, and lead to the easy transition bucket.
Singh trying to go around to Lancey. And Brasco is on the back of Theodore, trying to get the rebound. Already, it's a minute 34 left in this first quarter, and six foul team fouls already for Bishop Moore. So bonus from here on out.
Looks like the only way Bishop Moore is going to slow this American Heritage team down is to put them on the foul line.
Dumas, the Latson double teamed. That leaves Theodore open for this. The three is good. Boy, Imani Theodore's got off to a great start. Dumas almost came up with another steal. Claremont tried to get it inside to Singh, got it back. Double team down in the corner, back up to Tiffany Lee. Brasco along the baseline to Lee. Serenity Aragon doing a great job defensively.
I mean, just the feet and the white jerseys continue to move and in position, outstretched hands, nothing's coming easy for Bishop Moore.
The defense transition for American Heritage has just been so fluid.
It is very difficult sometimes to go back from a full court press to man to man, which they're seeming to do effortlessly. And part of that has to do with their ability to be able to switch to one through the five as well.
So far, it looks like a well-oiled machine. You just see the parts moving. They're all in the right place. Nobody ever seems to be out of position. A tough defense to crack.
Bishop Moore has to find a kink in the armor at some point.
Yeah, they're down 17 right now. Brasco puts one up, and Latson, excuse me, that was Desiree McGill who just checked in. That's Latson with the shot. Brasco has it taken away. Serenity Aragon came up with it, handed it off Gabriella Dumas. Lancey, step, tried to flip it up, got her own rebound, deflected.
How is that a 3-second call with the ball being moved around after a shot?
That was the quickest 3 seconds I ever saw in my life, if it was.
I think the referees are tired. Whew.
That will end the first quarter. And a fast-moving first quarter it was as American Heritage with the press and with the action of the Florida State commit. Ta'Niya Latson have themselves a 21-4 lead here in this girls' 5A state championship on Spectrum Sports. Welcome back. A dominating first quarter for American Heritage, and they lead Bishop Moore by 17 in this 5A state championship game, 21-4. Welcome back inside the RP Funding Center. Mike Cairns, Andrew Frazier on the call here. You look at Hardwood Dynasties, and you're looking at one right there. Consecutive state titles, and American Heritage can win their fifth straight here today with a win. Miami Country Day leads with six, but not only could they win their fifth, they'd be the third program to win five straight, but they'd be the first program in Broward history to do that. Dillard boys and girls each won four, and South Sumter girls won four. But no other Broward County team has ever won five straight, and they can do that with a win here today, and they're off to a good start.
You talk about being amongst royalty. I mean, Miami Country Day and Reball. Just
Brasco steps, trying to get around Serenity Aragon.
Check in the game with the Lady Hornets number 20.
starting to wonder about this pace for Bishop Moore. It's too rapid. They have to find a way to slow this basketball game down if they're going to want to compete for a title.
Merceron checks back in with two fouls. But they need her offense for sure. It's 21-4 here to start the second.
Loose ball foul here on the baseline. I think that's going to be shooting one, or they call that foul actually on American Heritage.
3rd team foul for the Patriots. Look at Ricky Clay Jr. in his first year. Edgewater grad's done a great job with his program, getting him in here. Right now, they're up. It's a tall task.
Edgewater's about a driver away, right, from Bishop Moore?
Yeah.
Especially the way you hit your golf club.
Oh, you mean then it's got to go right then?
Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. I was wondering what you're not straight. You're not talking a straight.
Yeah, line up with Edgewater on your left-hand side. You
okay.
Know, just teeing
perfect.
Off, you know, towards the north. And
hit
there
the
you go.
Slice. Okay, gotcha. Right. You know my game. Picked off by Aragon. And here comes Ta'Niya Latson. Latson with 8 points already here early. Aragon on the move. Latson tees up a three. It's good. Give her 11.
I'm not having a complete basketball game.
One of the most complete players I've seen here in a couple years. There was just so much fun to watch her in the semifinals. She could do everything. There wasn't anything... You know, you always think, well, you know, at this part of her game, that part, especially if you're trying to game plan against her defensively, you take a look at her and you go, I don't know. You can't double team her because she's got other teammates that can take the load. So,
and she's not afraid to pass the basketball. We're just so accustomed to seeing a lot of our high scorers at the high school level being volume shooters. She is a quality scorer and a better passer.
In quality rebound, she's not afraid to get underneath, mix it up. She can do it all. There's no doubt about it. Back the other way, and there's 2 points for Alexander Merceron. 24-6. Bishop Moore definitely needed that. Gabriella Dumas taking steps, turning the ball over. Sydney Studsville checks back into the game. For Greg Farias. Linnell Mosquita cross court. To Merceron, it's picked off.
Half court, 1-2-2 trap, just too far of a pass. And easy conversion bucket, rebound, and basket by Latson.
Just too easy. Picked by Sydney Studsville. And set up. The leading scorer today so far. She's got 13. Take another look.
Just got to make a decision. Like, you can't get to what we call dead man's corner. Like, you have to understand that the ball's going straight down the sideline. It's going to reverse to the guard who should be at least one step behind you. Too long of a pass. Easy read, pick, and score for the other end.
Now 5:26 left to go here in this first half. And Bishop Moore has got some work to do to catch up to Ta'Niya Latson and her crew. See the Sunshine State newcomer, American Heritage, Ta'Niya Latson, first team All-State in Georgia last year, helped us like the fourth straight state title, over 1,600 career points, Donald's All-American, and signed with Florida State. They got a good one. Brooke Allen down low, and Joey DeLancey got a piece. He doesn't like the call. They whistled her for the foul.
Foul call against number 22, Joey DeLancey, second personal.
Second personal for DeLancey as the junior now heads to the line. Brooke Allen had 13 points, 6 rebounds in the semis. And the one thing Coach Clate likes about her is she plays big. And he said she's had to play some players that are even bigger than her that they've matched up against this year. We played such a tough schedule, much tougher schedule than in years past. And Brooke Allen was always up to the task. But today she's going to go up against another task, and that's staring in the face, Agent Zero there, Ta'Niya Latson. Delancey!
Yeah, not a ton of size on this American Heritage team, but a ton of skill and versatility.
That was Theodule, my bad, on the call. The last bucket. Brooke Allen double team there, try to get Tiffany Lee on the cut. This is Delancey on the roll. Gives it up to Studsville. Step back and reset. With a little over 4:20 to go. And that call will go against Heritage. Bishop Moore will get the ball back. They're trailing 29-8. The combination of American Heritage's speed and that press early caused so many turnovers, led to a big lead. And that's tough to come back on.
Especially with the skill set of American Heritage.
You saw some of the scores in the open of what American Heritage did to get here. They won by some big numbers. Mercerron for two.
Great step through by Mercerron.
Dumas has it taken away. That's up and good. Marceline Clermont. Quickly back the other way, swatted away by Linnell Mosqueda. It's American Heritage, they want to get back quick. Mosqueda recognized that.
A bit of contact there, referees allowing them to play through, and here's a good job of not turning over the basketball to getting off a shot attempt as Clermont.
Kayla Smith comes in for Tiffany Lee. Kayla Smith's just an eighth grader, number 13. And she averaged about 10 minutes a game. And she does not play like an eighth grader. She just jumped right in. She knows her role on this team.
The last in here, just another gear as she accelerates off of that ball screen. Taking on the contact from Hooper and still has the ability to finish.
She's got 16 here. In the first half, we're still 3.5 left to go. Coming off of a 33-point, 8-rebound, 5-assist, 5-steal game in the semifinal. That is a stat stuffer. Mosqueda, there's the eighth grader, Kayla Smith. Mercerron looking for some help. Rasko turns, rejected by Latson.
Latson deciding to play in the post. Great post defense. I'll play behind hand straight up and just wait to get a block when you release it.
Dumas made it look easy. On the feed from Latson. I think that's what you were talking about Latson right there on that play. Unselfish. She could have taken it to the hoop, maybe sidestep, did something. She stopped, recognized Dumas was open on the wing there, and boom.
Totally unselfish.
That's what you talked about earlier. That's why she does everything. Mercerron in the corner, checked by Dumas. Looking for help. Trying to get it to Mosqueda. Mosqueda wrapped around with the right hand, draws a foul. Tried to go around Latson. And Latson will get called for her first foul this afternoon.
Latson caught, you know, just not able to come up with this actual steal, caught reaching and having to play recover.
Mosqueda will go to the line. Both teams are in the bonus here for the final 2 minutes and 21 seconds. First one's good. Look around at the crowd here inside the RP Funding Center. championship Saturday here on Spectrum Sports. Second one is good as well. Now a little pressure from Bishop Moore. Monty Theodule comes up with it, wraps it around to Gabriella Dumas. Dumas is on the run with the right hand, no good, but she got fouled.
Partner Dumas weaving in and out of traffic like you late to work. But the builder draw the foul. Good job of ball handling and not committing a charge.
Dumas to the line. First one is good. Just missed the second one. Skate on the ground, was almost tied up and then turned over by Dumas, and Dumas rolled it around. Theodule with the rebound, and she's fouled on the putback.
This team has so much grit and fight. Like every loose ball, they believe they have a right to it.
Skate with her second personal foul. The ninth team foul. Theodule's good. 78% free throw shooter. Brooke Allen checks back in. Second one on the way, 37-14 here, coming up. 2 minutes left in the first half. And the second is pure. Excellent free throw shooting team as well, 76% from the line. And that's a problem. There's nobody you can't foul and not get hurt by it.
Especially at the pace that they play, because they are always trying to shove the basketball down your throat.
Ta'Niya going to back it out, reset the offense. Dumas in the corner, gets it up to Theodule, straight on look, short. Dumas from the wing. Dumas and Brasco battling for the loose ball. We'll stay with American Heritage.
Even their misses are great misses because they get such good looks. It allows the offensive rebounders to get in a position to have an opportunity to try to create a second chance basket.
Latson checked by Claremont, and that's good. Gabriella Dumas with a three, another one for her. Dumas with a good first half as well. Theodule and Latson, 16 points for Latson, 15 for Theodule, and 8 for Dumas. And Tiffany Lee to the line, 5'7" senior. It's good. Under a minute left to go here in the first half. The RP Funding Center in Lakeland. Mike Cairns, Andrick Frazier with you on Championship Saturday here on Spectrum Sports. The 5A Girls State Championship is the defending champs. American Heritage on a roll thanks to that lady right there. Ta'Niya Latson, 18 in the first half.
Full speed Euro sidestep getting to the rim.
Claremont almost picked by Latson. And Latson covers up the ball. Possession arrow.
And the Lady Hornets take a timeout.
Favoring Bishop
Moore. I'm not even sure how they can take a timeout. Unless it's a jump ball.
The possession arrow was going their way. They didn't even need to take a timeout.
Well, I'm assuming they didn't call a jump ball because the possession arrow has not changed.
Right. No, they gave him the timeout. And for the Hornets of Bishop Moore, back on the big stage. For the first time since 2016, you can see they've been a bridesmaid a lot. They were champs in 08. They'd like to get a second ring today, but they are got a tough, tough opponent in American Heritage, who have a 43-15 lead. But Ricky Clay Jr. has done an outstanding job getting the Hornets back to Lakeland. for the first time since 2016.
Hornets are definitely going to have to sharpen their stingers. They want to get back into this contest.
Aragon with the foul. Sends Claremont to the line. Both with 9 team fouls, but with 28 seconds left. And a 5'7 sophomore is good on the first one. What would you do to try and change things for the second half if you're Bishop Moore?
I would probably try to call maybe some of the University of Florida players to see if I can get them to step in. No, I mean, this is a very balanced ball club. I mean, it's just – I think it's the speed and the pace of this game for Bishop Moore is too much. And honestly, you can't slow the game down being, you know, down 27. Like, it doesn't work for you. So they have to find ways to chip back at this lead slowly but surely. Definitely don't want to go down 30 into the half.
Lee misfires on the three. And that's how the first half comes to an end here at the RP Funding Center in Lakeland. The defending champs rolling through the first half, 43-16. The American Heritage Patriots leading the Bishop Moore Hornets here on Spectrum Sports.
Thrilling ride to the
Welcome back to the RP Funding Center in Lakeland, getting set for the start of the second half of the girls 5A state championship game. Mike Cairns and Andrick Frazier bringing you the call as the American Heritage Patriots raced out to a 43-16 lead over the Hornets in the first half. Take a look at the first half stats, and they are gaudy. They're bulky on the side of American Heritage, partner.
There's been a little bit of pressure,
partner, that's been applied by these Patriots, and I think that's really bothered the Bishop Moore Hornets. I mean, 0-for-2 from the three-point line, 20% field goal percentage, but the real big piece to be able to rebound the basketball and the turnovers. 23 rebounds for American Heritage, 12 turnovers for Bishop Moore.
And I think another key stat that you don't see there, 10 steals in the first half by American Heritage, and a lot of that had to do with that backcourt pressure and the fact that the pace, and you mentioned it during the broadcast, it just seemed a little bit too fast for Bishop Moore.
I think it's one of those things where they would like to play a half-court possession game, but they're going to be stuck now having to try to force the issue to chip into this lead. I expect to see a lot more of Latson to start this second half for the Patriots.
Yeah, and it's an uphill battle when you play a team that's played teams like this. You say battle-tested, they're battle-tested. Miami Christian, they played a 2A champ. You look at the 7A finalists and the semifinals in Colonial, 6A finalists. Dr. Phillips was a 7A finalist. DME Academy ranked 14th in the United States. And then, of course, IMG Academy ranked 5th in Florida. So they've played some people. And it shows, because the style that they play, it just seems like both of the teams I've watched here in the semifinals and then here in the finals, just no match for the style that American Heritage brings to the court.
They really look like they're in a very comfortable spot when, even when they're pressing, you know, they're never in a hurry, they're never rushed. See a big basket, make the right decisions in transition.
Tiffany Lee short on a three, first shot of the second half. Ta'Niya Latson tried to save it. Alexander Merceron will inbound here as we're just underway in the third quarter here on Spectrum Sports. The girls 5A state championship game. If you're just joining us, American Heritage dominating a big first half, and they're trying to build off it here to try to win another state championship.
Nice seal.
Brooke Allen with the left hand. Nice job. Brasco to Allen.
Great block screen there, and the ability of Allen to use her hip to create space between her and the defender to lead to the easy left-hand layup.
Nice way to start the second half. Put some points on the board. Studsville for three. That was nothing but net. So just when you're worried about the big guns, you get, oh yeah, there's some other players here that can fill it up. Merceron on the move. Too high for Brasco underneath. Turnover.
Yeah, we just talked about the speed. It's hard to recreate this pressure and size that American Heritage does in practice. So when you're moving at these speeds, being able to make the same plays you make at practice, you know, you'll have some errant passing. I think that's just what we saw in that last possession.
Latson with a big first half, 18 points to lead all scorers. Delancey. Another young lady who had a big first half as well.
These balls aren't even touching the rim.
Gabriella Dumas tried to save that. The stroke from Delancey was pure.
Another thing that's kind of impressive about this team, I don't know if you noticed this, partner, but on made threes, they've come back in a 1-3-1. On made layups, they set up in a full court press, and then they find ways to switch back. You know, once the ball goes out of bounds, the man-to-man. This is a very well-coached ball club.
Well, they got the rings to show it, that's for sure. Bishop Moore will hold on to the ball. Merceron. Wanted Brasco, but you can't get it over Ta'Niya Latson.
Just a shade late.
Studsville misses the layup. Tiffany Lee comes down with a rebound. Mosqueda flips it up and in. Linnell Mosqueda, 5'7 junior.
Bishop Moore taking advantage of a rare miscue by American Heritage.
Studville tried to step inside around Brooke Island, who got a piece of it. Nice save. Latson into our camera guy down there. He's okay.
Hey, it's a dangerous job down there, man. I hope all the workman's comp and insurance is up to.
He's a veteran. He probably got the look at. Look at this. He probably rolled right through it.
Let's see here. Latson coming right into your living room.
Oh yeah.
All of that.
Yep. Held on. That's quality.
Yeah.
That's quality.
Well, maybe the Seminoles will have a running game this year.
Skata for three. Latson comes down with a rebound. Got Studsville on the run with her. Latson's going to take it herself, but Tiffany Lee got a hold of her.
Foul call against number 11, Tiffany Lee.
Okay, Kenny, our camera guy's okay. I see him back up. Good.
As long as he's okay over
he's
there.
He's the man.
I can't operate a camera. I mean, I have to kind of stick to my skill set. I'm okay with a little microphone set on my head, but you ask me to operate a camera, times are going to be hard.
The best replay we got so far in the state championship game was from that man right there.
Appreciate everything these guys do.
They do. They
and
work
ladies.
Hard.
Yes, yep. This production crew is awesome.
The best. The best. From our producer, Chris McCauley, to our directors, everybody's been awesome. Make it so easy for us. Almost as easy as it was for Brooke Allen. Getting some points here in the second half.
They had an opportunity to break the press and get the basketball into the post. They've been successful so far in the third quarter.
Gabriella Dumas in contact as she went through the lane. Bishop Moore's not making it easy. Dumas gets up, shaking it off. Coming up on halfway through this third quarter. Still a long way to go if you're Bishop Moore, but some solid things to build on going into the fourth quarter if they can get a few stops. Keep knocking down some shots. It looks like they're getting inside more than they are settling for three-pointers. As Alyssa Brasco checks out, Gabriella Dumas checking over the wounds.
She's doing a much better job of handling the pressure, partner, but at the end of the day, you have to be able to stop this team from scoring. They haven't had much success in doing that so far.
Claremont and Mosqueda in the corner. Gets it to Tiffany Lee. Lee looking underneath.
Nice step through.
Couldn't get it over Joey DeLancey. There's Alexandra Mercer on. Mosqueda goes back out to the point. 4.5 to go here in the third quarter. Rejected by Latson. Feed ahead to Studsville. Studsville up for the easy layup. Nice job. And a great pass by Latson.
Latson just has such awareness. So she was supposed to cut through on the backside with the person she was guarding. But when you're two passes away, you should always have one foot in the paint. She elected to have two and be able to close out on the offensive play and get the block.
Claremont for three. Tiffany Lee comes down with it. Puts it back up. That rolls across the rim and another rebound for Ta'Niya Latson. The Florida State commit on the run. And that's going to be a turnover by Gabriella Dumas. Dumas has had a nice day both offensively and defensively. Come up with a bunch of steals, 10 points on the board. Tried to get it inside to Brooke Allen, went over her head. And it'll be American Heritage's ball.
Black jerseys are just too wide against this 1-2-2 zone. Your guards have to get a bit tighter. It's not a large looping pass.
Studsville from Latson, in and out. Theodore comes up with a rebound. He sends it back out to Dumas. Dumas is going to pull up, rattle around the rim. Nice job, Joey DeLancey gets inside, gets the rebound and the stick back.
Three cracks set on that possession for American Heritage.
Another thing that the pace does is wear your opponent down. Brooke Allen trying to get around DeLancey with the left hand. She was short on that. Merceron step around, little too strong. Claremont. And she's fouled by Delancey.
I think we've gotten to our point now where a 35-point lead is a running clock for the rest of the game.
It is indeed. Marceline Claremont, 5'7 sophomore. I think the one thing when I talked to Ricky Clay Jr. about his team is he talked about the experience that the youth are getting in this team. You look, Mosqueda's a junior, Brasco's a junior, Allen's a junior, Merceron's a sophomore, the young lady at the line's a sophomore, Simran Singh's a junior, and Marielle Hooper's a junior. All of these players have played in the semifinal and in the state championship game. That's what he's excited about. He goes, win or lose tomorrow, I know these girls are all coming back next year, and it's almost like you've got an even better start. You know, you're starting at a place where you're like, we could go back there again. We could make a good run.
No, it's difficult to get here in the first place, but to do it repetitively, you have to have people to understand what it takes. Not a lot of people really embrace the moment of understanding. Like, you may not get here again, and you don't know what it takes to actually get here. So you get younger players to get a chance to make the trip and, you know, stay up here for a couple days and, you know, be in a big open-air arena, playing to get some of the best competition, not only in the state but in the country. It's going to make them hungry and make them want to get back here more.
And I talked to Coach Farias about that. I'm like, how do you keep the girls who have won back-to-back state championships, or maybe even there are girls that won three in a row on your team, how do you keep them hungry for a fourth? He said, I don't let them – he goes, I don't treat them like they're – you know, they've won four state championships in a row. That's not how I coach. He goes, if you're going to rest on your awards, he goes, you're not going to go anywhere. He goes, that's not the way we are. And he reminds his girls every day. He's like, I want to win a state championship every year.
And that's in life. I mean, you have to be on to the next. You cannot – one of my favorite sayings, there's a reason why your rearview mirror is smaller than your windshield. If you spend a majority of your time in your life looking back at what you've done, you're never going to be able to move forward.
That's a great point. And I think this American Heritage team is the perfect example of not looking back. And all they've done is powered forward in the trips that they've made here, not only to get here, as you mentioned, how hard it is, but to win it.
I know we're used to seeing kind of some step-back moves, but that was a lot of movement without
that
a dribble.
It was a lot of movement. And that was right in front of us. Yeah. Couple of shots coming here.
You think that's distracting, shooting free throws with the red lights around the backboard?
Good job knocking that one down, and that will officially end the third quarter here of this girls' 5A state championship game on Spectrum Sports. Bishop Moore, a much better third quarter, but still a long way to go heading to the fourth. The American Heritage Patriots up big here on Spectrum Sports. Welcome back inside the RP Funding Center. Mike Cairns, Andrick Frazier. The girls 5A state championship game rolling into the final quarter. And American Heritage 8 minutes away from another state championship, and they are up big on Bishop Moore and try to hold off the Hornets coming down the stretch here. Yet one for the thumb. Alyssa Brasco comes down with the rebound. We're underway here in the fourth. Merceron. That's Sarah Shefstad, who took the free throws at the end of the third, has stayed in there to start this fourth.
Good dribble drive and shot attempt in that possession by Merceron, just coming up a little short.
Latson looking for more. Got inside and got the foul.
Because she shoots the basketball so well, you have to close out as a defender. Now watching her come off of this down screen, she attacked the defender's top foot. Textbook, you know, get 2 feet wet in the paint, try to draw contact.
I looked at her average. You know, she averaged almost 30 points a game during the season. She has the type of game. If she wasn't so selfish, she could average 35, 38 a game. She's that type of player because it seems like every time she touches the ball, if she wanted to score, she'd score. But she's not built like that.
It's one of those things, again, she's not a volume shooter. She's a quality shooter. And I think that's what makes her so attractive at the next level. Sometimes you get stuck watching great players, right? But she truly makes her teammates better by the way she plays.
I think you're 100% right. I mean, they say good teams are like a glove, and she fits this team like a glove. She's not the one person that stands out, although a lot of times she is because she's such a great player. But all the things that she does to get all of her teammates involved makes this team so good.
You know, she comes in and, you know, she replaces, you know, the Weiss twins who were here last year, you know, who have been so dominant. And, like, she fits into this piece of the puzzle. You know, like, she's been here playing for 4 years already.
Mariella Hooper at the line. Carly Lamore checks in. Ricky Clay Jr. getting a lot of his younger players in. Carly Lamort's a sophomore. Sarah Schiffstadt is a senior. But he's bringing in some of his younger players to get a taste of what it's like here. Lamort is number 25. And that's Sarah Schiffstadt on the ball, the senior. So getting some playing time in her final high school game of her career. Delancey. Just a smooth-looking shot.
Makes it look so easy.
It does. Really been impressed with her shot all day. Mercer on. Hands it off to Beatrice Ascio. Ascio is also a sophomore. That's Ascio on the drive. Latson. To Delancey. Again, there's that unselfishness. Easily could have taken it to the basket, recognized that she had somebody with her.
Making the right basketball play.
Mariella Hooper, long on the three. Nice move inside by Merceron. Good baseline move. Latson looks up at the clock. We're halfway through the final quarter of this
state
championship. Beautiful pass. Desiree McGill. But couldn't finish it.
Tell you what, freshman, you're going to miss some of that once she's gone. Still to be able to just to roll down and have the ball directly where you need it.
This is the eighth grader, Kayla Smith, on the line. Alex Guevara coming in, senior. As Bishop Moore has taken out all of their starters, except for Tiffany Lee. And she is at the point right now. It's Carly Lamort trying to get inside. Zaremba, a freshman with the shot there. Victoria Zaremba. Theodore, too strong with the layup. To Tiffany Lee. Lee. Nice move to get around Desiree McGill, but couldn't complete it.
Eighth grader there, just unable to come up with the pass.
She got herself in position, got up ahead of the play, but couldn't collect it. Lee, nice open look. The C parted and she went down the middle.
Go Great job, Botley.
Latson will go to the line and shoot two. American Heritage has not even got a team foul here.
Pressing in the second half. Matt, just think about what you just said.
I know, exactly. I just looked at – I just said, how do they not have a foul?
That is very difficult to do when you're pressuring the basketball.
Joey DeLancey going to get a big hug from Coach Reyes, Monty Theodore. And you can hear the crowd. Two seniors.
I think you have one last roar coming for you.
Two seniors are going to have some hardware to go home with. And there's a big hug for Ta'Niya Latson. Three girls playing in their final high school basketball game. And some with more to come. Tiffany Lee inside on the baseline has collected some buckets here in the fourth quarter. Looks like Gabriella Dumas is going to handle point duty. Sydney Studsville still in there. Dishes it down.
She did not travel. Oh, 3 seconds. Okay.
Megan Lamore checks in, the 5'11 sophomore. Megan checked in for her sister, Carly. Nyla Jimenez is in there as well. That was Sarah Shefstad on the three. Lee picks it off. Bishop Moore's got the number. She's going to fire it up. And that's the way the fourth quarter is going to come to an end. And American Heritage making history. They become the third team to win five straight and the first team in the history of Broward County to win five straight state championships. Congratulations, the American Heritage Patriots, your 2022 5A girls state champs.
And they made it look extremely easy this afternoon, but what an offensive performance. 9 of 17 from behind the arc, 18 of 24 from the free throw line, 14 assists on 21 made field goals.
And they had a host to help. Ta'Niya Latson with some of the big numbers scoring-wise, but she had plenty of help across the board. Latson finished with 24 points, 10 rebounds, 7 assists, nearly pulling off a triple-double as the Florida State commit leading the Patriots to a fifth consecutive state championship. Just let that sink in. Five straight state championships.
Especially with what we've been through, you know, the last few years with COVID and everything else. I mean, the ability to be able to be persistent, resilient, healthy, dominant.
Congratulations to the Patriots of American Heritage. They're winning their fifth straight state championship here today in Lakeland, 69-31. For my partner, Hendrick Frazier, I'm Mike Aarons. Hope you enjoyed this one this afternoon. The 5A Girls State Champ, the American Heritage Patriots, here on Spectrum Sports.
And now we recognize the players and coaches of the 2022 Class 5A state champions. Third year in a row in Class 5A and 5 years in a row across two classes, the Plantation American Heritage Lady Patriots and Coach Greg Faria. Thank you.